Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I want to try to control myself today and really calmly go over where we stand as a human population on this tiny planet and really break down the nature of the ruling class that is in control of our society and why they are engaging in a war against humanity, a war against intellect, a war against health, a war against truth. Why is that being done? Well, it's easier to break things and dominate things and wreck things than to build people up. And the globalists can just barely pull out every stop and engage in every dirty trick and do the most horrible things they can get away with against humanity and maintain control. They could not maintain control unless they were totally ruthless and pulled out all the stops and became pure evil. And they want the power, so they've done it. There's the answer in shorthand. But I want to try to flesh that out a bit, because knowing the enemy is half the battle. Knowing yourself is the other half. And, of course, taking action is the imperative, because if you know your enemy and know yourself, you will take action. But knowledge, being aware of things, the people perish for lack of knowledge really is the key. Now, if the global controllers really weren't just being competitive with each other and they actually looked further down the road, they would see the type of system that's being developed and being established is very, very dangerous for the ruling class itself, but there's an overall hubris, a nihilistic icing as well, or cherry on top of this dehumanizing confection that has been manifested. And if people think that's a scary paradigm I'm talking about, they haven't read history. Also, more and more I begin to realize that we are governed by fear. And I know that's an obvious statement. You're like, tell me something I didn't know, Mr. Sherlock. But do we really consciously understand what a mind killer fear really is? It is. And it is the attempt to go along with the system and the belief that that way leads towards success, sustainability, security, empowerment. That idea is the greatest lie of all. Because when you get a nation and a world of yes men and women, when you get a bunch of biological androids who don't consciously discover the mysteries of the universe for themselves, and who just do whatever they think is popular, you might as well just be a computer sitting here on a table. Because you're just going with whatever you're programmed with. And the message that go with this programming, do what everybody else is doing, and you'll be successful. Really, I see a lot of people doing what everybody else does that aren't successful. I'll tell you who really is successful in life, for good and for evil, and for all the points in between, that's mavericks, trailblazers, original thinkers. And that's why the globalists poison the food and the water and the culture and engage in that ultimate sin, is because they themselves are locked into a conformity of evil. They are locked in to a conformity of corruption. They are in their own mafia, their own gang, their own secret society, their own syndrome of psychopathic worldview. And they cannot break out of it. They fear the maverick true human. And their entire system is designed to dominate that which they fear. Now, I just laid the hardcore truth on you. We're going to break down the news and a lot more, and a big guest, David Icke, coming up. Stay with us. It is Thursday, the 21st day of June 2012. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Again, thank you for joining us for this hour of resistance against tyranny. Always informative, always thought-provoking. David Icke will be joining us coming up in the second hour of the worldwide broadcast today. And Mark Moreno was unable to get his internet working in Rio de Janeiro down there at the big UN World Government Conference yesterday. So he'll be joining us via landline in the last 30 minutes today. Lord Monckton tomorrow. I also talked to Billy Corgan of the Smashing Pumpkins yesterday. His new album's out. I'm going to tape an interview with him this weekend because he's about to leave the country and go do a tour in South America. And we'll be airing that. It should be on Monday or so. That should be quite informative. Okay. Where to start here? Obviously, there is the big news of House panel voting to cite Holder for contempt of Congress and the White House coming out and making the announcement that they're deploying executive privilege. Now, executive privilege is if you have as the president, a private meeting with an ambassador to discuss private matters of their government so that you as the president can understand delicate issues. And then somebody in the House of Representatives who wants to make a name for themselves or whatever demands to know what you said in that private meeting. And that's what happened with the first case of executive privilege and George Washington. Then it is kosher. But if you're Richard Nixon, who sends a bunch of burglars, FBI agents and people like G. Gordon Liddy to break into the Democratic National Committee's headquarters and to break into psychologists and psychiatrist offices to get dirt on people, you're not above the law. And that's the mistake Obama has made declaring executive privilege on this. This is not the type of executive privilege that's been upheld. This is a big sign that they are in hot water. And, of course, first they said that these documents didn't exist, that they're now declaring executive privilege on. And I am going to go back, in fact, maybe later in the broadcast today, because Rob Dew is out getting some equipment right now. I meant to tell him yesterday to get this. Or actually, I did say it over air, but never personally gave him the message. That I want the newscast we did earlier this year with the news clips from 2 years ago, plus, of the Attorney General, Eric Holder, the head of Homeland Security, Big Sis, Jan Napolitano, and others, talking about Fast and Furious and Operation Gunrunner in press conferences and talking about how they'd launched the operations. Now, the details weren't known. They were vague. But by admitting the programs, there they are admitting that obviously they, the heads of these big agencies, had given the orders. And the FBI, the ATF, the Border Patrol, the Coast Guard, and four other agencies, this all came out in the Chicago Tribune a year and a half ago. This all came out in the El Paso Times a year and a half ago. This all came out at Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com almost 2 years ago. In fact, we're always so busy covering the next news story that we rarely toot our horn. And look, we told you a week into it that Stuxnet was an Israeli-U.S. created program, probably working with Microsoft, according to our top tech experts that we had on. The Washington Post has been congratulated yesterday for breaking the fact that it was an Israeli-U.S. government/industry weapon, and that now a spinoff of that, the flame virus, is wrecking computers all over. And the government is simultaneously saying, give us more cybersecurity to take your rights away and to spy on you and put control hubs in everywhere in the infrastructure of all ISPs, even more that are there now with all the EAS crud, emergency alert system. And they are now pushing this entire takeover agenda on the backs of viruses they launched. Just like our criminal government illegitimate foreign banker occupied system. I mean, it's not the government. It calls itself that. Created Al-Qaeda. Had the hijackers trained at U.S. bases. We don't know exactly what happened on 9/11, but I mean, it's a fact. AP, Reuters, Newsweek, that generals and colonels at the bases said, my gosh, these guys on the news all trained at our base in spy training. In Florida and California, and they went public. And it was just swept under the rug. Never mind Muhammad Atta and the other hijackers with their government credit cards and living with FBI informants and visiting topless bars and being protected and running drills of hijacking jets. We know they were agents who thought they were taking part in drills that go on all the time. Try to get bombs on planes, try to get guns on planes. You know, that's why cops and others, if they try to hire you, to the feds do, to take part in a drill, most of the time it is a drill. But sometimes they're going to blow up a building and say, you did it. They're very sophisticated. Have you seen Arlington Road, where the terrorist? It's a very sophisticated movie because they imply they're really a government group. If you watch the movie, it's very sophisticated. They trick the professor, who they've profiled, who's a constitutionalist, into showing up thinking he's about to stop a bombing, and then he actually triggers it so they can have him as the patsy on the news. And that's the type of stuff they do. So you better understand that's how this works. The guys on 7-7, led by known MI6 agent, Fox News, BBC, Reuters, look it up. Exact drills of exact targets being hit at the exact same time, look it up. London Underground drill, they tell the guys, take these backpacks on. They were supposed to hit three buses and three trains, but instead they only hit two trains and a bus. A bunch of them figured out what was happening, ran for their lives, were gunned down at Canary Wharf. That even came out, but was shut down. Guys are running. The police shoot them, kill them all right there on the spot. Later, they killed a bunch of witnesses as well. I mean, this is what went on. I mean, the police would walk up to people in the street and on subways for weeks after. All right, hold them up against the wall and unload a clip right in their head, just getting rid of witnesses. Because they carried out that attack. And they got these secularized Muslims who wanted to climb to the social ranks and who'd been hired as informants to take part in drills, and they sure did, didn't they? They sure did. Exact bus and exact trains at the exact time and exact location. ITN, BBC, I could play the newscast for you right now. I've played it probably 50 times. If you don't believe me, just type it in. ITN, drills of 7-7 bombings, or BBC, drills of 7-7 bombings, and you'll have them admitting it. And why? To hide it in plain view, because if everybody's freaking out that took part in the drill and figuring out they were set up and used as cover in case other agencies that weren't part of it discovered it, or if things went wrong, they start speaking out. The program in the psych warfare manuals they're using is to go ahead and hide it in plain view and come out and say, oh, yes, we're running a drill of the exact same targets, exact same time, exact same place being hit. It's quite astounding. And then people see that and think, well, I don't have to whistleblow now. This is admitted. So I'm teaching you psych warfare secrets here, like a magician showing you the tricks. I've just reverse engineered it all. Later, I get declassified documents. It's exactly what I've already reverse engineered in my mind, but literally word for word, because I'm watching them do it and they're following manuals. So I'm seeing word for word what's in the manual. Let me give you another manual for false flags that, by the way, was in one of the WikiLeaks documents the Army admitted was accurate. Army captains and above who were in black ops special forces training for force multiplication have been taught at least since 1986 how to stage false flag terror attacks as a force multiplier. You're outnumbered 100-1. You know, in a month, the local group's going to invade that area. You commit a massacre. You kill a couple little kids down by the river, leave enemy mementos there to get the local tribe to unify behind you. And the argument they give these commanders is, you take the little kid, you hang him. It's very sad, but you'll save hundreds of children. You're strong enough to understand that, aren't you, Captain? Yes, sir, I'm ready to take this mission. Good. And 10 years after you've been killing little kids in the jungle in Force Multiply, you're loading explosives into World Trade Center 1, 2, and 7.